consider the extension q adjoined cube root of 2 instead of square root of 2 over q. This time, an automorphism phi of this field extension of q is completely determined by its value at cube root of 2. Why? Okay, let's think about what q adjoined cube root of 2 looks like. Cube root of 2, we know, is a root of x cubed minus 2. Which is irreducible over q. Why? You could apply Eisenstein's criterion. That works here with p equal to 2. Eisenstein's criterion is very specialized, but it is useful in situations like this. Apply Eisenstein with p equal to 2. And that means that the degree of this extension over q is 3, and every element of this field extension can be written as a linear combination of the basis elements, which would be 1, cube root of 2, and cube root of 2 squared. I could write every element like this. Where A, B, and C are rational numbers. And yes, it is fine to write that as 2 to the 1/3 if you like, and write this as 2 to the 2/3. It turns out that three numbers, 1, 2 to the 1/3, and 2 to the 2/3, are linearly independent over the rationals. The only way such a linear combination like this is going to be the number 0 is if A, B, and C are all 0. And it spans the entire set. It is ultimately then a basis for this. And that means the degree, well, the dimension of this as a vector space over the rationals is 3. The degree of the field extension is 3. And we could make a tower field seemingly like this and write a 3 there. And if what happened with example 1 were to work here, it would mean that when we think about the Galois group of this field extension over the rationals, it should, I guess, be a cyclic group of order 3 or something. There should be a subgroup lattice analogous to this, but there's not. This is a situation where the fundamental theorem of Galois theory does not apply. First, let's see why the Galois group is not a cyclic group of order 3. That's what the rest of the example is about. Well, why is it completely determined by phi of cube root of 2? Because of this fact here. You apply phi to an arbitrary such linear combination. Like this. Using the fact that phi is operation preserving and that it preserves all the rationals means this would become a plus b phi of cube root of 2 plus c phi of cube root of 2 squared. And that by operation preserving property would be phi of cube root of 2 quantity squared. That's why phi is completely determined by phi of cube root of 2. But you really don't have much choice in what phi of cube root of 2 is. Why not? By an argument analogous to this in example 1, phi of cube root of 2 must be a cube root of 2. What, plus or minus cube root of 2? No, there is no such thing. The cube root of 2, this symbol, cube root of 2, is the unique real number whose cube is 2. And it's positive, not negative. There are two other numbers whose cube is 2, but they're complex numbers. If you draw the complex plane, real axis, imaginary axis, the number 2, say, is right here on the real axis. The number cube root of 2 is, say, right about there. The other cube roots of 2, the other numbers whose cube is 2, lie on the same circle centered at the origin as the real cube root of 2 is. And the angle that they make with each other is 120 degrees. That's 120 degrees there. This is 120 degrees there. This is 120 degrees there. They're complex numbers. You could use trigonometry, effectively polar coordinates, to figure out what they are. Be specific. This one would be cube root of 2 as a real number times cosine of 120 degrees plus I sine of 120 degrees. Cosine of 120 degrees is negative 1/2. Sine of 120 degrees is square root of 3 over 2. Simplify if you like. That would be what that number is. There's I, that's the imaginary unit. And this one down here would be the reflection across the real axis. It would be the same thing except with the minus sign. Those are the other cube roots of 2, the other two numbers whose cube is 2. They're not real numbers. Therefore, they can't possibly be an output of phi of cube root of 2, because phi of cube root of 2 is an automorphism from this field to itself, which doesn't include any non-real numbers. Doesn't include any complex numbers that are not real. So the value of phi of cube root of 2 must be the real cube root of 2 itself. There's only one real cube root of 2. And this ultimately means the only element of the Galois group is epsilon. The Galois group of Q adjoining root cube root of 2 over Q is trivial. Just epsilon, isomorphic to Z1, you could say. A one element group, a trivial group. Actually, people don't typically write Z1. If you got a one element trivial group, they're more likely to write it as just zero. I mean, Z1, you could argue, is zero, but people typically just write zero. Zero under addition mod one, which doesn't really do anything. Zero plus zero is still zero. And so the subgroup lattice would be trivial. It's just that thing by itself. There's nothing to do besides write that thing by itself. And it doesn't match this. Does that mean the fundamental theorem of Galois theory is wrong? No, it's a theorem. But it means it doesn't apply to the situation. Why not? Let's look at the fundamental theorem of Galois theories. It's a very, very long, complicated theorem. That's just part one of it. It goes on to the next page. It's got parts 2, 3, and 4 as well. Whoa. Let's now look at the details of the theorem. Pictorially, it means the subgroup lattice for the Galois group and the tower of fields for the field extension are related and sort of flipped, is what it ends up meaning. All these details. Let's just look at the beginning. Let F be a field of characteristic zero or a finite field. Usually we consider the characteristic zero case in our examples. Usually considering things like the rationals for F. If E is a splitting field for F of some polynomial in F of X, then blah, blah, blah. That's the key phrase. If E is the splitting field or a splitting field for F for some polynomial with coefficients from the field. Q adjoining root 2 is a splitting field for x squared minus 2 over Q. Why? Because this completely splits in that field. What did that mean? It means it completely factors. This x minus root 2 times x plus root 2. Product of two polynomials with coefficients from this field. It's the minimal field extension of Q in which that happens. That's why it's a splitting field for Q adjoining for this polynomial over Q. Therefore, the fundamental theorem of Galois theory applies. On the other hand, with this example, this polynomial, this field extension of the rationals is not a splitting field for that polynomial over the rationals. Why not? It does, for one thing, it doesn't completely factor over this field. Why not? X cubed minus 2 can be factored. It is, in fact, the difference of two cubes. And there can be factored, therefore can be factored by our general formula for the difference of two cubes. A cubed minus B cubed, no matter what A and B are, is A minus B times, in parentheses, A squared plus AB plus B squared. Formula for factoring the difference of two cubes. If I treat the X as the A and cube root of two as the B, 2 to the 1/3, I can factor this as X minus 2 to the 1/3 times, look over here, it'd be X squared plus AB, 2 to the 1/3 times X, plus B squared, 2 to the 2/3. So remember, X cubed minus 2 was irreducible over the rationals. I couldn't factor it over the rationals. It is reducible over Q adjoining cube root of 2 because I can do this factorization, but it's not, that was not the splitting field because I can't factor that in the field. That quadratic. Why not? Because its roots are complex numbers. In fact, the other two complex numbers that I drew, these two things. Is there a way to verify that? Could use the quadratic formula. If you set this equal to 0, just this part, and solve for x with the quadratic formula, you get negative 2 to the 1/3 plus or minus square root of 2 to the 1/3 squared is 2 to the 2/3 minus 4 times 1 times 2 to the 2/3 over 2 times 1. That's the quadratic formula, which you could simplify a little bit to negative 2 to the 1/3 plus or minus square root of negative 3 times 2 to the 2/3. And that is going to involve I, the imaginary units. You could write that as I times the square root of positive 3 times 2 to the 2/3, which could be written, you could simplify it to I times 2 times square root of 3 times 2 to the 1/3. Okay, I don't know if that's any simpler, really. Anyway, the point is it involves I, the imaginary unit. And if you could ultimately show it does equal these two points, which are not real numbers. Therefore, yes, this thing is not a splitting field for that polynomial over Q. Therefore, the fundamental theorem of Galois theory does not apply. Can't use it.